right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Lon Shaver, the Vice President at Silvercorp. And Lon, it's great to have you back. How are you?
I'm doing well, Steve. Thanks for having me back.
So interesting news release out today is you've updated the 43-101 on your project. And this is interesting because this is really one of the first updates of the resource that you've done since 2016. So maybe before we get into all that, maybe just remind everyone a bit about the project and how this is not just one particular mine. There are a series of mines here.
Yeah, so the Ying Mining District is our flagship operation. It's the first one that began production. And it is made up of six mines that currently operate within the overall property package and feed into two mills that we have on the property. And if you look at our overall production, if we produce between sort of 6 and 6.5 million ounces of silver, it would be the bulk of that at say 5.5. And our GC mine in the south of the country is the smaller producer and is the one that came on 14. So Ying has really been the predominant driver in terms of the growth of the company. And the last time we had a 43-101 on Ying was three years ago off of drilling to the end of June of 2016.
So obviously there was that what's happened over the last 3 years, this stuff has been taken out of the mine. So this update now, in essence, would replace what you've already taken out. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, it's basically to bring sort of accounting forward in terms of looking at both the material that was mined and taken out of the mine, but also the ongoing drilling activity, because we do reinvest extensively in terms of drilling and tunneling to add to the resource and reserve life. And so this is a report that basically factors in those two components and brings up a fresh snapshot of what we see the mine being able to produce going forward.
Lon, what stood out to you in this new updated resource?
Well, I think the key thing is that through that production time period of June, which was the last drill results that were used in the last report, and then taking it to December of 2019, which is the last drilling that was used to calculate, you know, this reserve and resource, through that time period, the mine produced, you know, 2.2 million tons of ore. And despite that, this reserve calculation that we've put out yesterday basically effectively replaces all of that production. And so it's sort of brought us flat, if you want to think of it that way, in terms of a reserve base going forward. And on top of that, the actual grade of this reserve is higher. It's of higher quality, higher numbers than the reserve that was published 3 years ago.
Did that surprise you at all?
Well, you know, we've chatted before about the fact that we've, you know, even in late 2019, had some pretty remarkable drill results in terms of grades. And so it's really just a case of having, you know, generated those numbers, chased up and followed up on those zones. And then ultimately, you know, to sort of hammer it home, higher cutoffs were used in generating this reserve calculation. And that contributed to a higher grade in the overall reserve.
So what happens now? What's the sort of the next stage? Do you just continue with what you've been doing over the last little while? There's more drilling to come and all that. Is that sort of the next logical stage after you release something like this?
We've talked about recently that we've been doing another drill program. The drill program has been ongoing and we're continuing to develop, and none of the results and none of the work that has been done in 2020, you know, got factored into this calculation. But, you know, we wanted to bring this number forward. And so it's effective as of the end of December. And what it did in terms of looking at the mine at the end of December was say, hey, this mine is viable. It's got a 20-year life just based on these reserves, generates an attractive net present value of, you know, $713 million U.S. after taxes. And so that's kind of given a good snapshot for the future. But obviously, on top of that 20-year life, you know, we've got resources on, as well. And the work that we're doing is to continually optimize and add more and continue to identify higher grade portions that we can prioritize in the mine's production.
Well, it's an exciting time for sure, and exciting results as well. Lon, thanks so much. Great to see you again.
Great to see you, Steve. Thanks for having me.
All right, Lon Shaver, Vice President at Silvercorp.